Welcome back everybody to a brand new Unity 3D tutorial. In today's Unity 3D tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to add a splash screen to your game. So without further ado, let's get started. What you're going to do is open up the latest version of Unity. If you do not have Unity, I'll leave a link to it in the description for you all to go download. All you got to do is just sign up for a free account and sign in to Unity. And follow from there. Then once you'll install and launch Unity, you should have your custom project titled your custom project. So mine is not showing up. I just upgraded from 2017.3.1 to 2018.2.1. So I'm gonna go to my file explorer and find the project that we've been working on. All we're gonna do is just click open. I'm gonna grab my JJG project. It stands for John Games Project. And select the folder. And it's gonna open up Unity 2017.3.1 to 2018.2.1. Click and click continue. Because since that project was made in 2017.3, we're going to update the project to 2018.2. And here we go. It's gonna load up our project. While it's doing that, I'm gonna pause and come right back. All right, Unity now launching up. Our scene should be still the same once we updated our project. Further in the beginner series, I'll show you guys how to upgrade or update your project from Unity 2017 to 2018. Alright, you might see some errors, but we just hit clear. What we're going to do to add our splash screen, file, build settings, and scroll kind of all the way to the bottom where all these different platforms, there's Facebook, Universal Windows platform, PS4, PS Vita, Xbox One, tvOS, WebGL, Android, PC, Mac, Linux. There's a Switch platform button, which is off by default. What you want is player settings. Click that one. It will show an inspector panel. Alright, we're going to change our default. First, we're going to change this to this. If you have an icon, all you gotta do is just import it to Unity and just click this. Make sure you set it. I'll show you guys how to add a default icon and all the other settings further in the beginner series. From here in the inspector panel, scroll down, it says between resolution and presentation and other settings. There's a splash image, hit that. The first virtual reality splash, if you're developing a game for virtual reality support, if you have application config, you can do that as well. We're going to get to that later on in the series. Where's the splash screen? We want logos, we want all see. And then animation here, on our splash style, there's dolly, which means it's going to come in and go. It's going to come in and disappear. Staggering means it's going to come in static, fade in static, and fade out static. So for me, I'm going to choose the static animation. The duration of the logos, you all can go up to 10.5, or the plus icon underneath the Unity logo duration. Hit the plus icon. That simply add a new logo. Now we're going to go import our logo image. I'm going to use my logo for example. We're going to right click on this. Go to our logo import settings. Go to texture type versus default, click on it. You want to switch it to sprite 2D and UI and just click apply. Now we're going to go back to file, build settings again, and player settings to go back to the splash screen. Exit out of there and we can add our logo image. Select, I'm going to type in the name of the logo. There you go, just click on that what image you just imported, exit out. Now if we preview this, just up here it's just says show the splash screen, just click preview. That's the static. Oh, maybe change this to 5. Alright, I'm showing you how the dolly works. Click preview. Yeah, it fades in and zooms in and fades out. Same thing. That's the dolly. For the static, just versus dolly, hit static, then preview. It's gonna fade in and fade out static. Just like that. You can change the different background color. You can switch it to like a white. See what happens if we change it to color. Preview. That's pretty cool. I'm gonna go to file, save project, save scene. It will be saved by default. It will be saved, so you don't have to mess with all the settings. That's simply how to add a splash screen to your game, and that's simply how to add a splash screen and nudity 3D. If you like this tutorial, slap a like on it. If you're new here, please subscribe with the notification bell clicked. You don't want to miss a single upload. Also, check out my game dev website, linked in the description, jmgamedevtutorials.blue.com, where I have added some UI scripts that you can download for free if you're a beginner, and they're free use only. If you use those scripts, give me credit, because I don't want to create those scripts. Also, I have added UI assets, too. Check out my merch in the description. There's one for Streamlabs and one for Rage On. If you'd like to donate to help support the stream, the channel, link to it will be in the description as well. You don't have to, but it's an option. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next Unity tutorial. Yeah.